Welcome to this tutorial for exporting your results from an EBSCO or a PubMed database into Zotero. I would like to begin this session with an acknowledgement of country. I would like to acknowledge the Turrbal and Yuggera traditional owners of the land on which I am recording today. To begin this session, I would like to mention that it is a good idea to have created an EBSCO account into which you can save your EBSCO results. This is not required for PubMed, but for EBSCO it is required. You can learn more about this by watching the EBSCO Discovery basic searching video and navigating to the timestamp, which talks about creating a profile in EBSCO. Once you have run your results, you can save your results into your EBSCO folder by clicking Share, Results, and selecting the folder where you would like your results saved. Then navigate to the folder at the top. You can find your folders on the left-hand side at the bottom. Click Articles. Select the articles you want to export. If you have more than 20, it will flow over onto a second page. You'll need to do a second export for this. I will just work with the single export today. Once you have selected the articles that you would like to export, click Export and ensure that you have the first option selected where you're exporting to a reference manager or Zotero. Click Save. And if you have Zotero extension on your computer, you can click OK and it will automatically download the Zotero file for you. You can create a folder and it will download into the folder you have created. If you don't have the Zotero extension, then you can also download the file by clicking Cancel. And you can see that it's downloaded a little delivery here. To import this, simply open Zotero, click on File, Import. And yes, we want to import the RIS file. You select the file that you want to import. Click Next, and it will create a new folder with the delivery. If you want to include these in a previously made folder, you simply click the first one, press the Control button on your computer, and run down the list, selecting the items you want to move. Then click, drag, and drop into the folder where you want to relocate the delivery. These have now been added into the folder. That is how you export from an EBSCO database. It's the same process for any EBSCO database, whether you're using CINAHL, Medline, or Discovery Search. If you're using PubMed, it's a bit of a different process. Once you've run your results, you click on the Save button. You want to make sure that you have the option for PubMed selected in the little drop down here. And then whether if you want all of the results on the page, or just a selection, or all of the results in the entire results list. Click Create File, and it will download a little delivery, as it did with EBSCO. And to import this, you simply File, Import, confirm that you want an RIS file, and then select. It's once again downloaded them into a new folder. If you would like to merge these, you can run down the list again, selecting the articles you wish to add into the folder. These are all the results I want. I'll click drag and drop them over. And because this is a combination of both EBSCO and the PubMed searches now, I will just rename that to this subject code. If you want to see whether you have any duplicates with Zotero, you can navigate down to the item here, duplicate items, and this will oversee whether you have any duplicates within your entire collection. You can click on the duplicates. It will give you a quick overview of what you can see in each duplicate, and then it will merge the two items. These two items, if there is any information missing in one of them, it will be filled by the other one if the information is available. And it's as simple as going through, merging the items that are similar into one single item. And that's how you export results into Zotero. If you have any further questions or would like some more information, you can book in a consultation with your librarian through this link on our homepage. Thank you.